In this video, I will show you how to take the equation of a hyperbola that's in general form and rewrite it in standard form. So basically, we're going to complete the square. Your first step needs to be to group together your terms that have the same variable. So this has a y and this term has a y. So these two terms need to go together. I've got my x squared and I've got an x term here. These two terms need to go together. When you do it, keep an eye on the squared terms. Whichever squared term is positive, that's the one you want to go first. So we have 4y squared, that's positive. I'm going to lead with that. So I will have 4y squared plus 8y because those go together. Notice I have this negative 36x squared. I will definitely make sure to put that squared term second because it's negative. And then it goes with the minus 72x. Okay, it's equal to 176. Before we can complete the square, we need to deal with these coefficients in front of the squared terms. So I need to pull this 4 outside of parentheses by dividing everything by 4. So then I'll have y squared plus 2y. Leave space to complete the square. I also need to take this negative 36 outside parentheses. So I'm dividing everything by negative 36. So I will have x squared plus 2x, leave space to complete the square, is equal to 176. So now it's time to complete the square. Half the middle squared. So half of this is 1. 1 squared is still 1. So I'm going to put a plus 1 right here. Now be careful. I'm not going to put a plus 1 on the other side to balance this out. Because of the 4 that we pulled out, this is really 4 times 1. So I need to put plus 4 on the right-hand side to balance out that change. Similarly, when I take half of this, that's 1. 1 squared is 1. But here again, negative 36 times 1 is what I really have. So that's why I'm going to have to put a negative 36 on the right-hand side to balance out that change. All right, time for some factoring, y'all. So I'm going to have 4. And then, of course, this will factor as the same thing twice. Y plus 1 times y plus 1 minus 36 times x plus 1 times x plus 1. Okay, just add these three numbers together. So that is 144. Let's rewrite this putting y plus 1 squared and x plus 1 squared. Okay, so I'm going to have 4 times y plus 1 squared minus 36 times x plus 1 squared is equal to 144. Okay, so I just wrote the same exact thing, but this is y plus 1 squared and this is x plus 1 squared. For the standard form equation of a hyperbola, we always need equals 1 on the right hand side. That's why we know to divide everything by 144. Okay, now we need to reduce these fractions. How many times does 4 go into 144? How many times does 36 go into 144? Turns out 4 goes into 144 36 times. So this is going to be y plus 1 squared over 36, which of course means that 36 goes into 144 4 times. So this will be x plus 1 squared over 4. Equals 1. So that's it. This is the standard form equation of the hyperbola. Let's practice that one more time. So again, we need to collect are variables that have the same, are terms that have the same variables. So these two terms need to wind up next to each other. And these two terms need to wind up next to each other. The 256 needs to wind up by itself on the other side of the equation. So I'm going to start with the 16x squared because it's positive. So I will have 16x squared. Now I'm going to have to add 64x to both sides. So when this 64 gets to the other side of the equation, it will be a positive 64x because I added it to both sides. Okay, I'm going to have to subtract 16y squared from both sides. So when this gets to the left-hand side, it's going to be a minus 16y squared. That's why it's second. But then I have the plus 64y that was already there. Now I'm adding 256 to both sides. So I will have 256 on the right-hand side. Okay, before I can complete the square, I need to pull the coefficients of the squared terms outside of parentheses. So I'm going to have 16 outside of parentheses. So 64 divided by 16, that's 4. So I'll have 4x. Leave space to complete the square. All right, and now here I'm pulling out a negative 16. So 64 divided by negative 16 is going to be negative 4y. Leave space to complete the square. So now it's time to complete the square. We do half the middle squared. Half of this is 2. 2 squared is 4. Now to balance it out, I need to recognize that this is really 16 times 4. So that's 64. So I need to add 64 to the other side. All right, we'll do half the middle squared again. Half of this is negative 2. If I square it, I get positive 4. Now, negative 16 times positive 4 is negative 64. So I'm going to have to put negative 64 on the other side to balance out this change. When I go to factor this, I will have 16 times x plus 2 times x plus 2, and then minus 16 times y minus 2 times y minus 2. These 64s cancel each other out, so I just have 256. All right, I'm just going to rewrite this, but with x plus 2 squared and y minus 2 squared. So we have this. We know that for a standard form hyperbola, it always has to have equals 1 on the right-hand side. So we will definitely divide by 256 everywhere. Okay, so how many times does 16 go into 256? Well, that's 16 times. So this is going to reduce down to x plus 2 squared over 16 minus y minus 2 squared over 16 equals 1. So this is the standard form equation of the hyperbola. So that's going to do it for problem number 8.